Welcome back, guys, to the Kingdom of Jerusalem campaign. So last time I ended by beginning a siege against Aqaba, and I realized something. The odds are against me. They don't have to be. I noticed that the biggest army that they have, it's outside of the city. So if it's outside of the city, I can actually break siege and then go around and attack this army without it triggering the whole garrison. And then we can auto-resolve it. Easy win. That army runs away. And then now we can attack the city without having that huge army. And that's what we're going to do. Much easier this way. So always keep in mind whether the army that you're dealing with, is it inside of the city? And then you have to fight it inside of the city either way. Or is it outside of the city? Makes a huge difference. There's a sandstorm. Let's see if it'll pass. That's good. Cool. Lighthouse. So this city doesn't have a wall, which will make it pretty easy to deal with. Looking good. All right, let's start the battle. Now our enemies stand on their walls. All right, they have some. They have some naval units.
Now they look down upon you with contempt. So, show them how foolish they are, how misguided, and how God.
So they're gonna land. Is that all they have?
The enemy has been spotted. We outnumber the enemy.
Yeah, let's deal with these guys with the heavy cavalry. It's the best way. Oh, instantly slaughtered. And killed their general. They have about 300 men left.
Our general is being attacked!
50 left. Let's deal with these archers. All that remains. Pretty good ratio.
Ready for orders. It is a great and glorious thing to serve your people.
Alright, end of turn. Oh, unassigned skills. They're laying siege to Aleppo. I guess the wall wasn't repaired yet. But I think I'm gonna end the video here. We already fought one siege, so we'll fight this one next time. Don't forget to give it a like if you enjoyed the video, and see you guys in the next one.